Well, thanks for joining us, Jolanda.
You're welcome.
So we've been hearing in the course about Ash's line length study and how people sometimes go along with the group. And often how that's interpreted is that people conform, the majority of the people conform at least some of the time to the group. Is that the main message we should take away from that study?
Yeah, I guess the studies have always been seen as showing in a very powerful way how important it is for people to fit in, to be part of something, and how stressed they actually get when they feel that the responses are not aligned with others. So they're even happy then to sort of go along with a majority that's clearly incorrect. So if that means that they can just don't have to stand out as the only person who says something different. So that is a very powerful demonstration of a conformity effect. But it is interesting that if you actually look at the studies and the way that also Ash wrote about that, it's very clear that there is a lot going on in that study, and there's a lot more to say about those studies. One of the interesting things is, for instance, that Ash was talking after the study to his participants and asked them, so how did you go? Well, what did you think was going on? And it is interesting that, interesting, also a bit sad in a way, that participants felt quite upset. They were very distressed. And in very different ways, they tried to make sense of what just happened. So it must have been a very bewildering experience for them to sit there and to see all these people call out wrong answers when it's so clear that they're wrong, right? So you must start to worry about everything you believe in, your own eyes, everything. So how do people make sense of that? So when you actually look at how Ash talks about these studies, you see that a lot is going on there and that there are many different ways in which people make sense of the situation. So one of them, people typically will say, look, maybe it's just that there's something wrong with my eyes, I must not see this correctly. And they truly believe then that, look, let's just go along with the majority, that seems to be the most sensible thing to do. There are also those who see that the first person actually giving the wrong answer has glasses, so they assume, oh, maybe there's something with his or her eyesight. And all the others are too polite to point out that the person gave the wrong response. So they sort of say, look, I'll do that too. Let's not sort of put that person on the spot. So there are all these different theories that people develop to justify what they're doing. But it is interesting too that if you read what Ash is writing about, it is, a few things are interesting. One is that it becomes clear that yes, there is a percentage of people who will conform on the critical trials, but there are also quite a lot of people who resist and stick to what they think they believe. So that must be quite painful. For half an hour you go through this routine and everyone seems to be seeing something else and you do, but you just stick to that. And it is interesting to see what those people say afterwards, and they will often say, look, they say, I don't know what's going on around me, I don't listen to them, I can only tell you what I see, and this is what I see. So they also come up with a way of dealing with a very difficult and bewildering situation that they find themselves in. And that expresses itself in sticking to what you think is happening there.
Does it sort of tell us about some of the things that lead people to resist the group?
Well, actually, if you look at it, the majority of responses is showing signs of rebellion. Most of the time are actually people sticking to what they think they see and don't go along with that incorrect majority. And so it seems as if they almost negotiate what they see, being true to what they see, but at the same time also trying to be a little bit respectful to all those other people there who, for whatever reason, are giving all these incorrect responses. So sometimes they say, yes, yeah, you're right. You know, I'll go along with the majority that gives the incorrect response. So it looks as if there is a bit more going on than conformity versus rebellion. People try and negotiate the situation, trying to make sense of this situation. And I guess actually what is happening there and the way that people make sense of that situation comes also across when you look at all the different variations that ASH had to that classic paradigm. So in one, for instance, there's one other person who also sticks to, deviates from the majority. And that is interesting to see because the naive participant is so grateful for that. There's one other person in the world who sees what I see. So of course then you see that conformity levels plummet dramatically, right? I'm not the only one who sees something else. So that's very powerful. And interesting about that even is that plummeting of conformity levels even happens when that person who also deviates from the majority also gives an incorrect response. What is even interesting here is that you find that conformity levels drop dramatically when there is a confederate who also deviates from the majority, but also gives an incorrect response. Right? So even though you know that there's a majority who gives the incorrect response, this one individual who gives an incorrect response, but the mere fact that they also deviate from the majority, that is reassuring and allows you then to stick to what you think you're seeing right in front of you.
So these studies tell us a bit about the pressures for conformity that people experience, but I guess in our day-to-day lives, we're not often asked to judge the length of lines in a group of other people. What are some of the behaviours that we might experience these pressures for conformity within our real lives?
Yeah, that's an interesting point, and you're absolutely right that the situation that these participants found themselves in was very unusual, something that they had never experienced before, having to judge these lines, but perhaps also it is not something that they cared too deeply about. So one can wonder what kind of findings you would have if it was about issues that people care deeply about, their personal beliefs, their political opinions, etc. So that is a bit of a question. Would they still be willing to go along with a majority that is sort of saying something that they deeply disagree with? So that is an interesting point, first and foremost. Maybe there's one other point I would like to make, and that is that we often look at it as if these people do something that is so irrational and it shows blind conformity, that it is something that we wouldn't expect. But I guess, and maybe this is an important point to make too, that very often we do, of course, look at other people to help us to understand the world around us. So if other people see something that we don't see, then that is deeply disturbing, and we're trying to make sense of that. A lot of the learning that we do in our lives is through conforming to or listening to what other people say and taking that on board as something that will help us to understand the world. It's just in this particular experiment, you could say that people are being fooled in a sense that they can no longer trust their senses. So it's a powerful demonstration of that particular clash there. But it also does show the power of conformity and the importance how important people think that it is to have their opinions and their views aligned with others that are important to them. And this has been used to explain things as diverse as bulimia, where people give in to peer pressure for certain and that regulates their eating behavior. It has also been used to explain hooliganism. Why do people actually go along with the crowds and perhaps engage in violent behavior and more extreme behaviors, even the type of behaviors you could see in Nazi Germany? Why do people actually go along and engage in genocide just because that is what the majority seems to condone of?
Excellent, thank you.
You're welcome.